Sorry, guys. FC Investor checking in. Really early in the morning. So, alright. So I made some changes to my chicken machine. You can see here, actually, when we log in, this, the redstone gets broken, and it stays on an on state, which you have to refix every single time you log in, which is tedious work. I actually put on the dispensers here, which I can refill with several eggs, and you can see how many, how much sand this machine actually makes. And this is relatively, like, 40 seconds of that machine on, of both machines, actually, the pork chop machine as well as sand. Tons of cooked pork chop. I realize on a couple of PvP servers, you can actually make this machine, this chicken one, pretty easy if you can go purchase some eggs. Because, like I said in my previous video, it's actually a 1/8% chance for a chicken to spawn when you throw them. And I do know that on some servers, you can actually pick up pigs. Pig spawners. In 1.9 you'll be able to pick them up with silk touch. The machine is broken right now. I have to fix that. But right now I was actually going to work on a new aspect of this factory. If you guys have any suggestions or tips as to what I can add on, go ahead and post a comment below, please. Now let me just tell you a little bit of the changes I made. I put signs here, which trick mobs into thinking that there is a block there, so they'll actually step down more often. They'll fall in there more often with signs. And when they're on fire, they'll run around and start spazzing out. So see how a lot more are actually falling down there. And I'll fix how that works. I realize there actually has to be one. I think there has to be one airspace for the mob spawners to actually work. So there has to be one space above them. I don't want pigs spawning right now, so I'm just gonna remove them all. And yes, it'll take me a long time to get this spawn back. I'm actually using the inventory edit, if you guys didn't realize that, because I'm playing on 1.8, as you can see, I'm not sure if this was in my last video. I think it was. Basically, this, long repeater that lets down water periodically to wash the cooked pig down the chute. I'll show you guys that later, but right now I'm just gonna have this on so you guys can check me out while I'm working on maybe a cactus farm or something. Everything's gonna be connected to this chute, not necessarily glass, because I don't want to do glass, it'll take too long. So let's see what I can do here. If you want to actually make water go in there without reversing the flow, you're going to have to make it exactly, I think, 8 or 9 spaces, I'm not sure. I'm pretty sure it's 8. We're going to see here in a second. I'm pretty sure it's 8, though. Let me go ahead and get a bucket here. and then I'll stop the video while I'm building the base and show you periodically. There you go. See now when you throw something down, it'll fall in here, and shoot. There go the eggs, starting to come up again. Faster rate this time, and I'm confused why chicken fall down here, but, I mean, it still works. They'll still lay eggs there, and it'll go down this chute. There's basically a column right here where I can make multiple chutes, but this here's gonna be a cactus farm, I believe. Although I'm in a desert, I can really just plant cactus anywhere, or collect all that cactus. I mean, let's just go through the renewable resources that can be collected, like an auto farm. Okay, pumpkin seeds can be collected like that. Melons, cactus, sugarcane with pistons, I guess. Mushrooms, but they're really, really slow. Pork chop, wheat, but you have to replant it, which is very tedious. Doesn't really work too well in an automatic farm. Oops. You know, cake is technically a renewable resource, but you're gonna need cows nearby. How about I just make a melon pumpkin farm? I hate making cactus farms. Basically, what you do for a cactus farm is, you want to have a cactus first, and some sand. Basically, you have a cactus in the ground here, and you want to make sure it breaks off right there. So, when it grows up one, it'll fall off. It'll, because this block is here, and cactus break when there's a block next to them. So, and then you put a sand. This is why I really hate this, because you sort of have to do this before you put the cactus down or else it'll break. And it's basically just this pattern repeating vertically until you hit the very top of the sky, and then you do it multiple times. But once you get the first one done, it's just as easy as dragging it across and breaking one every other block. See, and it works. But oh, you actually don't need to break every other block. Well, yeah, it's every other block. And basically just that pattern. I like to use glowstone because it actually works, but glowstone's a pretty rare resource. Well, it's not rare, but I mean, like, in PvP servers, they can be hard to get because sometimes Nether is disabled and you have to resort to purchasing it, which I dislike. So, I'm gonna go ahead and work on the melon farm and bring you guys back when I'm done. Hey guys, just a really quick update. I actually just realized that this machine is impractical in terms of redstone, because, well, both ways would be rather impractical, and this entire factory is really impractical in SMP, unless you can actually get that many pig spawners, but you don't need that many. You can just have like one layer of this machine with one pig spawner and it'll still yield a pretty high yield. But I realize that since I log back in every single time, I have to reset these redstone that are stuck on an on state, which is pretty much all of them. And since they're all set on a one-tick timer, I can actually just have one central repeater unit. Now, if you guys don't quite understand what I'm talking about, let me show you here. You can actually extend redstone wires, if you guys haven't realized that. Redstone only lasts for like 15 units. I'm pretty sure that's more than enough. And it dies off at the end here. Well, that was exactly enough. And you can see it doesn't power this. But if you put a repeater here, it resets the 15 amount. Now, if instead, and it's pretty instantaneous too, I mean, because the repeater is set to 1. So now if I powered it with several, not several, but a tick timer, I'm pretty sure the result would be instantaneous signaling. Seems like the signal is shorter because 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. No, just 2. So I'm going to have to move it up by putting a redstone repeater here. But the signal itself. Oh, wrong block. Whatever. Doesn't change much. Yeah, you can see here that signal extension isn't actually 100% good if you want to extend a one tick timer, because the repeaters can't register the signal as fast as it actually is spamming it. Because if it's spamming it like that, the repeaters can only register at 3 different speeds. So that'll just be basically a battery almost. That'll just repeat it. Try to close an iron door there. Eggs. Don't actually have enough inventory for that. But check that out. Isn't that cool? Ow. Yeah. So that's pretty much it. I realize this video can be a lot shorter, but whatever. Everyone likes long videos, don't they? No, they probably don't, but whatever. Don't want to redo it. So deal with it. I'll post another video as soon as the melon farm is done. So, see you guys later. I'm checking out after I blow this entire dungeon.